All right, thanks for joining me. So to make this job a little bit quicker, we're gonna warm up the generator. This will help get the oil to flow out faster. And so we only need to run this about 3 to 5 minutes, or if it's actually pretty hot where you are, you can probably go ahead and skip this step. So we're gonna need a spark plug gap tool, a Phillips screwdriver with a number 2 and a number 3 bit, also a 13/16 spark plug wrench, something to catch your oil and fill the oil, and your oil, which is a 5-weight 30, and some gloves are also helpful. We'll get this side panel off real quick, take out these two screws, then we'll go ahead, remove that, get it out of the way, take off the little spark plug access hatch, and that's what we're going to start with. We'll remove the spark plug boot up and out of the way. We'll take our 13/16 spark plug wrench. We'll get this guy out, take a look at it. I haven't serviced this generator, so don't know the condition, but that spark plug actually looks brand new, so we're going to actually keep it. No reason to replace it if it's still good and working, but if you did, you can see that either it takes a torch or an NGK spark plug. I'll have a link in the description down below. And you would gap that to either 24 to 31 thousandths. Anywhere in that zone would be fine. So we'll go ahead and put that back in, and feel free to stop the video or fast forward as needed. That way you can kind of skip along and figure out what part you may need to go to. All right, so we'll put that spark plug boot back on. We're gonna go ahead and move to the air filter down here. We'll take the little cover off. And then as you look at the air filter, it's actually pretty clean. And so we'll take that, we'll inspect it. The air box looks great. And this filter, actually, it's not really dirty at all. It has a nice thin layer of oil on it. And if this was dirty, you would just put in like a bucket of Dawn dish soap, and then you would want to dry it completely and then re-oil it, which you would put in like a sandwich bag with just a little bit of oil, like a teaspoon is really all you need. So it has a thin coat of layer of oil on basically the whole filter on the outside of it. So, but since it looks good, we're just going to go ahead and put it back in, and we're going to go ahead and move on to our oil change. So make sure the air cover is snapped on completely, because you don't want that to be misaligned. So we'll take a look at our oil level here. And if we take a look, you can see it's actually full, which is great. That means it's not losing oil or burning oil. So I'll try to show you here a little bit of focus, but all right. So what we're going to do now is we're going to drain this out here in just a second, wipe that off. Now, you can actually get one of these oil extractor devices, kind of like the one shown here or the little one. But in all reality, this is actually quicker. If I was to get my oil extractor out, I'd have to get it out of the box, kind of get it all set up real quick, which doesn't take long. And then, you know, then you extract the oil, and then you'd have to get rid of the oil and then go ahead and put the extractor away, which you can see I've already got it out. And the oil is pretty dirty, so it definitely was due for a change. But yeah, this way is just actually pretty quick. Just putting in a little container, a little pan, and then you dump it into your kind of waste container. So our new oil is going to be a 5-weight 30 synthetic. It only takes 13 ounces, or about 4 quarts. And so when you put this in, you want to put it in kind of slow. You don't want it to backfill on you, so take your time. I'll speed up the video so we don't have to kind of wash the oil drain in. And so we'll get that all filled up, and then we'll let that drip into the container there. And what we're going to do is make sure it's all the way full. And the easiest way to tell is just by basically looking at those threads. If you have oil on the threads or at the bottom of the threads, it could be at the top as well, you're good to go. Or you can check it with the dipstick if you like, but usually just checking it on the threads is the easiest method. So we'll do a quick cleanup there, get our oil drain plug back in, wipe up any mess that we might have, because a clean generator is a good healthy generator. And we have one more step, so we're not quite done yet. We'll get that spark plug access port back on. And if you guys do like this video, give me a thumbs up. Let me know if you guys want to see more of these or know more of these. Yeah, you never know. So we're going to move on to the last thing, and that's going to be checking our flame arrestor. So we're going to pop off all these screws and get off that exhaust screen that's on the back. All right, so you see the exhaust screen right there. The flame arrestor is actually attached to the inside of that. So there's one screw that we have to take off. And remember, the engine could be hot, so take care of that. So we'll take out the one screw. We'll pull out the exhaust screen with the flame arrestor. As you can see, it's actually not that bad. There's hardly any dark soot on it. You would know, because it would be really black. It'd be all over my glove. And you would just clean it with a bristle brush or a wire brush like this until it's clean. But that's not really any fun when you can play with fire like this. And so basically all you have to do is torch, and it burns off all the basically soot and deposits that are on it. It's almost kind of like how a diesel truck works when it does a DPF regen. It burns off all the soot that's in that diesel particulate filter. And but we're just kind of doing the same thing manually on this flame arrestor. So that thing is hot, so we're going to put it back in. We're going to get our screw, and then we'll go ahead and put that back together. I'm going to use the pliers just because that thing is hot from torching it. And then we got to get that exhaust cover. We're going to put that back on, and the tabs on this one are actually at the top. Some are on the bottom, but anyway. So we'll get our screws, we'll put that back together, and leave a comment down below, or if you guys have questions.